do the same shit. I ain't put it on autopilot.
Today, from MetLife Stadium in New Jersey, it's week 13 of the NFL on EA Sports.
The bye weeks are over. It's all about time as we're underway here in week 13.
Takes this about 5 yards deep and no run back here, so they'll bring it out to the 25.
Monday, down, ready.
Watch the slap, watch the slap, watch the slap.
57, ready.
First rep of the game for Josh Jacobs. And right away, they're going to stack him up right at the line of scrimmage. Calling no gain on the game's first play. And it's second down now.
Defensively here, you're facing a top five team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high power, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20. Because to me, that's the magic number. 20-point score gives yourself you give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
And I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
28 yards the gain there on the catch and run. So in jet territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 47. That's the number two receiver in the NFL in terms of yardage. And tell you what, if he plays like that, he won't be number two for long.
But that's what often happens when you have competitors running around the field. These guys know where they stand in relationship to yardage, totals, numbers, the whole deal. And let's face it, all of them, they all want to be number one.
On second and 12, Carr. It's complete to Golden Tate. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. 25 yards there on the catch and run.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And they have result there. Nice first down. Drive keeps
hit, bruh.
Linebacker C.J. Mosley there in coverage.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Here's the first carry for Kenyon Drake, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
Throwing his car on third down.
Come on, man. Look at the hole.
Jets defense making things difficult there. Fourth down.
They really had a good drive going there, but a nice recovery by the defense. He's passed
like 43-42 yards.
Third down and bring up what I think for the offense, an unexpected fourth down here.
The kick by Carlson is good, and the Raiders jump out to a 3-0 advantage. It'll continue to be interesting in these wet conditions how these kickers fare, but first test, passed.
And how about how the special teams unit handled that? A lot of concentration to make sure the ball didn't slip through his fingers. After the snap, got it down and let him pop it through the posts.
their own 17-yard line.
And they'll come out with a three tight end look on the first play of the drive. First carry for the former Falcon, Tevin Coleman. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. 16 yards right off the bat on a first down. That run successful in large part because they had a lot of...
I ain't there.
Extra help blocking up front.
Yeah, you've got guys who can do that very, very well. In addition, they can catch the football. So sometimes when they line up with three tight ends, it's not necessarily to run it, and that gives you an advantage when you do decide to barrel off the line of scrimmage and block people downfield.
And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. Boy, 30 more yards and another first down.
38-yard line.
Right back to him on first down. Fighting his way down to about the 35-yard line. The numbers for him from a week ago. And Charles, how do you think he ran the football?
I thought he definitely had his moments. I did think that they could have utilized him a little bit better. And I'm definitely going to keep an eye on
get
him
first.
See how they're going to use him this week.
The reception good for seven. It's third down.
Ran a perfect defense in this situation. Would have meant that there was an incompletion, they would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
There's a first down throw that's complete. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. A gain of six there on first. So second and four from the 22. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Flush to his right.
Oh, this nigga's so soft, bro. I stopped.
He was looking for Jamison Crowder there. And it'll bring up third down.
As soon as I saw him break contain and get outside,
right,
my first thought and my eyes gravitated downfield because nowadays, most of these quarterbacks, when they do that,
oh my god, bro, this nigga's so sorry.
In this case, he took the shot. It fell incomplete.
The Raider defense
first down.
On that one in coverage.
I got a lineup first.
Here we go on fourth down. And he will have the first down before he's tackled at the 12. Give him credit. They knew what they wanted to dial up on fourth. They executed it for 9 yards, and the offense stays out there. Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. And he's going to take it in for a Jets touchdown. A great effort there with touchdown number 23 here on the year. And the Jets have taken the lead. People always talk about one of his biggest strengths running the football, vision, and he found the spot there, went into the end zone.
You're exactly right about
that. Boy,
winning
assist three.
Vision, right? Once he saw the gap, decisiveness, made up his mind, and about the power to finish the play. Not only did he get good blocking, he created his own space as well.
And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback. Henry Ruggs and the Raiders set to go back to work. For him, what an accomplishment in this game.
Damn.
Surpassing the 2,000-yard mark. And all the time we talk about these
guys. He got 2,000 yards with Henry Ruggs, bro.
He can do so many things, but take us a little deeper. How has he done it this year?
Well, you helped with this because when we sat down with him before
mad at that nigga.
And discussed his season, and you said to him, okay, I have a vision that you, similar to a pitcher, change up a lot of things, right? Different arm angles, different slots that a pitcher would do. You do that with your route running and all that. And I loved his response. He said, yeah, I do that. But one of his best friends is a world-ranked tennis player, and he talked about serve. He can change up, take pace off, do different things, and he incorporated that into his route running.
That one good for 26 and a first down.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
Here's Jacobs.
Oh, I've seen that shit.
20, 10, and he will score. Touchdown, Las Vegas. Josh Jacobs. Touchdown number 22 on the season. And once again, the Raiders are back out in front.
Josh Jacobs, boy, I tell you, he is a complete package. The power that he has to run through you, and then he's also got the speed to run away from you, as we saw there.
I think defensively, when you look at a play like that, that's when everyone looks at their teammates and starts shaking their heads a little bit, because now you're wondering, what are we in for? Worked all week to try and limit the big play ability that he possesses, and he winds up taking one to the house in the very first quarter. That was a tremendous run.
And he covered a lot of ground on that one, as evidenced by the final total there on Next Gen Stats.
A look at the running back, the man out of the backfield, as he gears up to go again. A tough challenge here in this one. We'll see if he can duplicate the numbers on your screen that he put up last week, up over 100 and a touchdown.
We were watching tape to prepare for this game. One thing you noted that I totally agree with, great complimentary piece in the last game. You know, they're able to throw it pretty well. He ran it exceptionally, and he hoped to continue that same formula in this game.
Complimentary with an E, not an I.
That's my English teacher right there.
And he's in. Touchdown, Jets. Jamison Crowder, 76 yards. And the Jets have once again taken the lead.
Yes, sir.
And his kick is no good.
Dog, this shit crazy, man. How, bro?
Second quarter now from MetLife Stadium. The Jets with the football here, but likely not for long as they're in punt formation. Set to kick this one away, and off it goes. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there.
He hurt. Every game, some nigga hurt.
The Raider offense set to get this drive started. And it's only November, but the playoffs, we know how it works. They'll be here before you know it. If it were today, they would be the number one seed.
And that's a great
pick, bro.
But I love the phrase, if it ended today. And I guarantee you, that's what they've discussed in their locker room, in their meeting rooms.
Why y'all playing like this?
But we also know it's not ending today.
Pit the ball.
Continue to play the type of ball that put them in the spot where they're number one in their conference.
They'll run the jet sweep with Brown.
Ooh. And not much. Third and one? 30 inches?
About the 36. Just a gain of a yard there, and now it'll be third down.
Let's just make this one succinct. Nice job there. All 11 guys on defense diagnosing the jet sweep and putting it down.
Now Carr on the bootleg.
Oh, my God, dog.
And he is going to have the Raiders first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Give them 22
there on the third down conversion. So in jet territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 42-yard line. Here's Carr.
Good shit.
Rush coming, and he's taken down. Just not much a quarterback can do there, CD. The pressure was in his face almost instantaneously, led to a very quick sack. Carr with a play fake to James.
Get off the fucking line.
He uncorks it for Snead.
Out of bounds.
Taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play.
Oh.
They say it's incomplete.
Why they play the zone like that?
A little too far, it brings up third down. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Shotgun now for Carr. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. And he can only manage to take.
Come on, wind blowing. He shouldn't make this shit.
They pick up 10, but it'll still lead to a fourth down.
One of the money routes for any offense, the drag route. So tough to defend.
Good shit.
The receiver can stop at any point and make himself available to the quarterback and get a completion. But I love the communication we saw there. All the defenders pointing out the receiver where he was going, and then they're able to rally to the ball after the catch and stop him short of a first down. Now, if this was a clear day in September, I'd say this is well within his range. I feel very confident about this kick, but let's be honest about it. In these elements, the difficulty level gets ratcheted up by at least a factor of five.
A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down.
It's a gain of 9. Brings up second and a yard.
Now a handoff here to his running back.
That's fucking bullshit.
Not enough there for a first. No gain, as a matter of fact. And it leaves him at third and one. Maybe I'm wrong, but it looked like even if he had opted to keep that, I don't think there was going to be much to gain.
Seemed like it was perfectly defense. And know what they say? Those guys on the other side, they get paid too.
And he is going to have a Jets first down as they're able to convert by plenty there on third and one. And now for him on the season, that is his 80th catch, and the result is a first down. And he'll give it here to his running back.
75, you got to hold your block, bro.
Down to the 37-yard line. The last run got a couple here, second and eight.
And this is why aggressive defense coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D lineman to make the play.
And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Give them 14 on that one and a first down. Throw complete to Herndon. A gain of six there on first. From the 17, here's second and four.
A six-yard pickup brings up second and four at the 17-yard line.
On play action, they'll throw. He's got Herndon, his tight end. And he's got this inside the 10 to the 9 before he's out of bounds. Four catches now on this drive alone. They can't stop him. It's another first down. They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway.
Block, bro. God damn.
Quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. Hustling through to break that play up, Max Crosby. And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. And he'll be taken down here at about the 11. The second down play, not much better than the first, just a gain of one there.
It's now third and goal.
Play action fake. They'll look to throw. The Raiders
get hit
strong on that one in coverage, and now it's fourth.
Well, we always talk about how you've got to be quick when you go through your progressions, and here's another prime example. Trying to look downfield, he's standing in the pocket, but just couldn't find anyone open, could he?
No, not enough time. They hit him.
My God, dog, this game, man. Huh?
So we've seen these be tricky from time to time. You know, you've almost got to cut the ball to make it go through. And this time he cut it a little too much and he sliced it.
Yeah, and he'll tell you, no excuses on this one. It's a kick every NFL kicker should be able to make in his sleep. But your word was definitely correct. He sliced that one and he'll miss it wide to the right.
And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
Pick, bro.
Left side by John Brown. The Raiders gonna use one of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute.
They be cheating for a computer, bro.
So second and eight here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down.
We can't get off the line. Look at this shit.
Complete to his running back, Kenyon Drake. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done.
Matt know what the fuck they're doing.
Go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one.
Come on, we gotta get some pressure, man.
Car now on first down.
He ain't fumble. How?
Inside the 20 at the 19.
How?
A gain of six there on first.
How?
I respect both sides on that play, CD. For him to be able to hold on to that football and the impressive tackle.
Did you notice the look between the two of them as they came off the ground? That look did say the word.
How the man ain't fumbling, bro?
And the Raiders are going to have a first and goal as the tackle made at the 10-yard line. Now a signal and a timeout call as it comes with 9 seconds to go in this first half of play. So it's first and goal and a great opportunity to get that lead back before the break. Carr to throw again. And this is called.
Oh, this is fucking animated, bro. So I couldn't jump and grab the pick. Okay.
Final seconds of the first half.
Okay.
A lot of people might call this backyard football. Sometimes just understanding who you got out.
That's a fucking pick. They just brought me. To go up and make a play, even when contested. It's like that would work out really well. The trust factor, in effect. So with 3 seconds remaining in the half, they will line up to kick this one away. Fielded just outside the goal line.
So we've reached halftime here in a four-point game. As we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, thank you very much. We're starting to get near the home stretch of this NFL season. It's week 13, so let's get an update on what's going on. We'll begin of it.
You want the third quarter already? No problem. Let's do it. Forecast calling for more of the same. The rain set to continue as we are underway in the second half. That'll be taken about a yard deep. Jets offense coming out now to start their next drive. And the last time that they were a little demoralizing, this is going to be always feeling like getting an end zone, but then this one is going to be mental process as a team, doesn't it? But you need to keep this confidence up, because how many times have we seen games where coverage comes to a stretch, and guess what? You need that guy to make the big kick for your team to move on or to win a game. Make sure you keep him happy. Make sure you keep him comfortable.
I'm sure you always treated the kicker nicely, though, right?
You know, truthfully, I did. Good. I always did, because those guys, they won us a whole lot of games.
Okay, just like that. Just like that.
They'll run with Coleman on first down. And some room to work. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. He's able to rip off 32 on that one. It's a first down.
One thing that's great about watching him run, Charles, he doesn't hesitate. He got to the left side of his own line and just went.
So there's two ways to look at that. One, just absolutely unconcerned, just takes off and goes. But more the latter, I think, which is he has absolute confidence in the guys in front of him, the guys doing the blocking for him. He just takes it and goes with abandon.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line.
Boy, where would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Quan Alexander.
Oh, yeah, good job. The pass. Good job.
So it was a drive that had real promise here to begin the third quarter, but ultimately derailed by the INT.
And that was the position you wanted to be in. Coming at the start of this third quarter, get a nice drive going, looking for the end zone. Possibly got a little bit too greedy right there.
6 yards on the pickup, and it'll make it second down.
Caught that look from you there, partner. I think we're on the same page on that one. Just his first catch. I think we both thought he'd be a little more active in the passing game. Let's see if that's the start of them trying to get the ball to him a little bit more here in the second half.
He's got the first down and more inside the 40. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down.
Pardon, if you want more carries, I think we saw how you get him. Showed that he's got the fresh legs, and he picked up the first down on that run. Don't just show him that you're supposed to get the football.
And he'll get this one down to about the 27. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and 9.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough in run support. And I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
Henry Ruggs, the rookie, his intended target. And that takes us from second to third down. Now here's a timeout defensively. Defensive timeout called by the Jets. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave them trying to convert. On third and 9. From the gun, it's Carr. Letting one go deep for the end zone. And this is intercepted, but they'll say out of bounds. So very close to a turnover there in the end zone.
But that was certainly an aggressive call and an aggressive play. Instead of just going for the first down, took the shot in the end zone, went for the touchdown.
And on third down, they said, forget about the sticks. We want six. challenged the play. It did not pay off.
And that means he lost a timeout in that challenge.
And as a coach, you hate that. Don't know if you took the advice of the player. You threw it yourself, but it didn't go your way.
At the end of the day, it all comes back to the head coach. He has the final determination on whether to actually challenge the play or not. In this case, it didn't pay off for him.
And that's got to be so heartbreaking. You throw that flag, you probably feel really confident, and then all of a sudden, boom, you lose the challenge.
Yeah, when you take a look at it, you're throwing that flag because you believe you're going to be right. And when it comes back the other way, you have to regroup.
Yeah, they bucked, dog. That was a fucking INT, dog. This shit be tripping, dog.
This crowd are happy with that call.
How the wind is got it curving like that?
Trouble. First and 10. Down six, and they know they'll need these for the fourth down. They'll go for it. It's good. Now a desperation shoot.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And this game may quite over yet. We'll likely see some extra timeouts defensively, so they can't just dribble this one out. They don't have to try to run a few plays.
You're exactly right. They've got to get a first down and make them use up all their timeouts in order to feel like they have this one in hand.
This is all probability. Another run here on second down. And the Raiders are going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. Now it looks like he'll throw here. Oh, there's the end again. It's going to be late. After the penalty, a first set of downs, it's first and ten. They'll try to run some clock here as they're keeping on the ground. This thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Every time I gotta pick up Kiki. How long has Crystal been asleep?
Coming up now to start the next drive. And this is a little bit of a shift. And pleased to take that over the Seattle Seahawks. Meanwhile, for Las Vegas, thank you.